The most powerful view type in Airtable, in my humble opinion, is the list view. The list view allows you to look at multiple layers of data all in one view. And what's more, if you include it in an interface, you can get even more powerful, even more granular with what you let people see and edit and create. So in this video, we're going to be breaking down the power of the list view, specifically using it in an interface. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you to get organized and automated with no-code tools. No-code tools can help you save up to 20 hours a week if you're leveraging automation and organizing your operations in nice, succinct workflows. So if you are newer to Airtable, or maybe you've been using it for a while and you just want a quick refresher to make sure you know all the different features, I invite you to first, before we jump into things, grab my Airtable Crash Course. This crash course will be delivered to you in a series of emails over about a week. We're going to go through all the key features of Airtable so that you can master all of the different elements of this amazingly powerful tool. Grab that crash course at garethpronovost.com/airtable-crash-course. I'll be sure to include links wherever you found this video. But without further ado, let's hop into the heart of things. We've got to talk about the list view in interfaces, but before we get to that, we have to first do a quick recap of our data schema that we're going to be using. And I want to also talk at a high level about what the list view is. So first and foremost, what we have here is a fairly common setup. You'll see this style of setup in multiple places as you work more and more inside of Airtable. I have three key tables, and each table is linked to the next. So I have projects. Projects are my top level, and a project links to multiple tasks. So every project is going to be comprised of more than one task, right? So I have a linked relationship here that says, look, I've got a project. I know what type of project it is. I have a start date, an estimated end date, and then the tasks assigned to this project. So let's flip into our tasks. This is the second layer. In my tasks, I have the name of the task, which is just a formula. I'm combining here the task name and the project. So here's our link back to projects. And of course, a task is assigned to someone, in this case, just me. And then I've got a project start date. I'm able to look that up. So of course, this lives at the project level. I'm looking it up here. And I also have a due date for this specific project. But now you'll notice that I've got another layer because I'm linking now to time log. So the idea here is that we are going to have a log of our time, and each time log will be specific to a project's task. So in this case, I've got project one, task one, two, three, and you can see that I've linked to some time logs here. So let's go to the third and final layer of this structure. Here on the time log table, remember this is linking to tasks, we can log our time. And so somebody in this case might come in, we have an auto number here that's just automatically generated, and this is the user, in this case me, and here we're saying, look, I logged time against a task. I was working on task one. I put in 2 hours of effort. I started at noon. I ended at 2 p.m. Again, I did the same thing, noon to two on a different day. And again, from noon to two on a different day. So in total, I have logged 2 hours times three different instances. So 6 hours against this task. Task one, project one. So again, we've got three layers here. I start with the project. I come down to the task. And then finally, I link down to the time log. Again, this is a very common theme that we're gonna see over and over again when we're building Airtable bases like this, where we have multiple layers of data. But this is where the list view is so darn powerful. If you've never used the list view, what it allows us to do is to see multiple layers of data, multiple tables worth, all in one place. And the best part is if we build it in an interface, we get even more control. We can say, hey, I only want you to show me stuff that is assigned to a certain person, for example. Let's look at it one step at a time by first going into an interface. We will start by creating a new interface from scratch. I don't care what we name it, just for the example, I'll call this interface 2. Let's go next. And here, as you can see, Airtable is trying to push the list view on us. Airtable knows how powerful this is, and this is the first option currently available. So It allows us to organize and prioritize, but that is barely scratching the surface. I'm going to make that selection here and click Next. Now, it's going to ask us what table we want to look at, and I'm going to start by looking at the most granular level. That is the third layer down. So if you recall, I've got projects, tasks, and time log. Well, I want to look at my time log. That's where I'm going to start this, at least for now, and let's go ahead and finish it up. Now, inside of here, I am able to now assign various levels of detail to my time log. So if I go to list options right here, I have the ability to add levels of hierarchy to my list. So I will say try it. And here I can go through, click through these screens. I want to get started. Remember, I am at the lowest level, the third level down. I started with time log. I'm going to add a level above. The table above time log is tasks. So I add that. I can add yet another layer above that, which is my third and highest level. In this case, that is projects. And so it's saying, okay, I've got projects, which link down to my tasks, which link down to my time log. Again, the schema that we're working with, that's why we started there. We looked at the database in the first place. It matters how we've linked our tables and linked our data in order to get the functionality we want. So now that I'm here, I'm going to go ahead and click Next. And here is where I'm going to tell it how these things link down. So projects links to tasks because in the projects table, there's a field called tasks. Yours might be called something different. Whatever you named that linked relationship from this level to the next level, we need to make sure that we're telling Airtable, this is the linked relationship where I want you to focus. This really only comes into play if we have multiple links to the same table. If we linked projects to tasks a couple of times for various reasons, well, then we need to make sure we're finding the right linked relationship here. And again, we're going to do that at the next level down as well. Also note that we can enable nested records for this table. I'm not going to do that in this example, but this effectively gives us almost like a fourth layer of detail inside of our level. So I'm happy with the way this is looking. I'm going to click Next. And here's where I'm deciding what information am I sharing on the view. Remember, I'm able to see all this stuff at once. And this is what's especially unique about the list view, because normally, if I want to see projects, I have to go to the projects table. If I want to see my time logs, I have to go to the time logs table. But here, I can see all three different levels all at the same time. So what information do I want to bring in? Well, maybe on the project level, I want to know what type of project. I want to know what's the start date. Now, I don't care about any of my links to tasks because I'm actually going to get the next layer down. So here's my tasks. I might want to see who that's assigned to. I might want to see what the due date of that task is. I might also want to see what the task name is. Notice that I can just toggle these little elements on and off, and I can rearrange them just by clicking and dragging them. Pretty simple. Lastly, over here on time log, maybe I want to see all of it. My start time, my end time, all of it. Now, once I'm happy with what I'm showing, remember that this is what is happening and being shown on the actual list view itself. So I'm going to go ahead and click Done, and it's going to generate this report. Now, here is what I'm looking at. This seems like a lot of data, maybe a lot of noise if we start off just by getting overwhelmed by it. But let's shrink some stuff down and think about what we have. We have layers of data. This first layer is the project. This is the project. This is what we said we wanted to see on this. We want to know the type. We want to know the start date. Next layer down, these are my tasks nested under that project. So notice that I can collapse the project and open it up. I'm going to see the tasks that are assigned to that specific project. So here they are, task 3, task 1, task 2. Inside of the tasks, one further layer down, I have my time log. So here is my time log, and I've only recorded 3 different time logs for project 1, task 1, and so that's what we see right here, right? So there we go. Now, that's it for putting the view together, but the part where things get next level cool inside of interfaces is where we can limit permissions. So first thing we want to do is back up from our time log, and we're going to actually click on open here. And it's going to ask us, do you want to allow your interface users to actually open the record details of this particular time log? Now, note that when I clicked on open, I'm clicking the time log level. I can also do that at the task level. I can also do that at the project level. So remember, I have 3 different tables worth of data that I'm accessing here. I can click each one of these and go in and say, I want to allow my users in my interface to open the project right from here. So I'm going to say allow. Okay, now once I do that, this is the little side sheet that comes up. I love the side sheet that is available inside of Airtable interfaces. But I can also opt for full screen if I want. So that when somebody clicks on this, it's going to take them from that list view and drill them right into the detail of the project. Now remember, they clicked on the project. It's going to open up that project. Or, as I prefer, keep it on the side sheet. That way I can just kind of shut it down right here when I'm done working on this part. Now, just as I could inside the list view itself, now I'm in the detail of this record and I can edit what shows up here. So I can move the tasks, I can ditch them. Maybe I don't want them to show up here. Maybe I want to rearrange where this estimated end date is looking. So I just click and drag it. I can make things bigger, smaller. And here's where I get even cooler. I can also click these elements and allow people to edit them inside of the detail view. Note that this is different from editing in line inside of the list view, which I'm going to show you in just a minute as well. But here I am, if I want to allow people to edit the end date of a project, boom, just click right here, say editable, and we're good. Now that's it. I can do this at every level. So remember, I did this at the project level, but I can do it at the task level. Click allow, and then build out that detail. I can also do it at the time log level, right here. Click allow. Now I can only do this when I'm in edit mode for my interface. So of course I am currently editing an interface. Once I publish the interface, nobody else will be able to ask the interface and grant these permissions unless they have creator permission at the interface level, right? If they're not able to edit the interface, then all they can do is work within the way the interface is set up. But if they're a creator in the database or in the workspace, then they'll have this level of permission and they can start changing the way others interact with it. So the next thing I want to look at is how we can apply inline editing. Over here on the right-hand panel, I have this right here on my allow users to section at the bottom. So I can apply some filters. I can apply the clicking into record details. This is where we were just working. Remember, we have the different layers here. Here's my projects, here's my tasks. Here's my linked records. So I can access all these different layers within here, just as I showed you by clicking open. But what I want to focus on is right here, the inline edit capabilities. Maybe I want to allow my users to just edit stuff here in line. Right now they would have the ability to edit all tasks. Maybe I want to change that to only allow them to edit specific tasks, like tasks that have not yet been marked complete or something like that. I can apply different rules to this so that people can edit stuff directly in line. And then when they come in, they can just hover right over here in the list, highlight what they want to make a change to. Maybe they want to change this and link it to a different task. No problem. They have that capability if I allow them to edit in line. So it's two different places that we're granting edit level permissions. We can edit in line of the list view, or we can edit inside of the expansion of the record if we allow people to, in fact, expand the record. Now, I personally prefer to keep editing off. I like editing in line. I don't like to make that available. And instead, I say only when you open this up, like in the case of opening the project, and then I can go in and line by line, field by field, I can decide what people are going to edit. I like that level of permission better. I feel like it presents nicely and it's a little easier to understand. A lot of time I feel like when you have inline editing, mistakes could be made. Things might get edited inline by mistake, and I want to avoid that. But whatever your preference is, these are the options before you. Now, the last thing I want to point out here is if we go back to the list element itself, the list view, I can choose what kind of data people see. So here I click on what users can see. This is where I can apply filters to the list view and make it so that the people can see only the stuff that pertains to them, only the things I want them to see, etc. So at this level, I can say specific records. And notice that the source here has the different layers. So what projects do I want you to see? Maybe in this case, for this particular interface, I only want to see the projects of type 1. Well, you notice that right now I'm seeing project 4, project 5, they're different types. Well, all I have to do is say at the project level, I want to bring in specific records. And the condition that I want to bring in here is that I want to say the project type is type 1. And just like that, I've eliminated the other projects right from my view, right? Now again, I can go in at a different level, go into tasks, and now I can assign certain rules for tasks. Now lastly, let's go into time log, assign certain rules for time log. Maybe, for example, I say, I only want to see those time logs where the user is the currently logged in user. That means if I'm logged into my interface, I see mine. If someone else is logged into their interface, they see those tasks that are assigned to them. So this is how we can go in at the different levels and change what people have access to right here in the interface. Now, the last piece here is to know that once I go in and I start tweaking all of those different elements as I just did, sometimes I have to go back and reset all of this data. So it forgot, as I was drilling in and saying, I want to create different permissions for the time log, for the tasks, I messed up the hierarchy that I'd already established. So I have to go back in and reestablish that just as we did earlier in the video. I have to make sure that I'm bringing in the data that I want to on these various elements and go ahead and save it up. Now, when it comes to allowing people to see specific things inside of the list view, we have a lot of control. Remember that we have three different layers of data here. We have projects, tasks, and time log. Well, in order to filter through this data, what we want to do is click on our list options. Now, from here, if I click on my filters right now, you'll see that I have no filters. I can apply filters at any level of data that I want. So for example, here I've got all my projects listed. Well, maybe I don't want to list projects of type 2 and 3. So I can simply set up a rule here and say I want to filter only type 1 into my list view. So I say at the project level, I'm going to add a condition that says I'm looking at project type of type 1. And now just that easily, I've removed from this view any projects and the data inside of them that was not project type 1. Similarly, I can apply a filter for user permissions as well. So maybe I only want to see those tasks and those time logs that are assigned to me as a user. Well, I can go in and say tasks, add a condition, where they are assigned to is the current user. Current user is a dynamically flexible variable, meaning I can put this in and whoever is logged into the interface is going to see those things that are assigned to them. This allows me then to assign tasks to people on my team so that the people on my team only see the stuff that's given to them and they're not going to be bogged down with a lot of other noisy data that belongs to other people. I can do that both at the task level and also here at the time log level as well. Now this one you'll notice, because this is the third layer down, this is configured in the properties of the page. So in order to access the third layer of filters, what we need to do, go back here and in the properties of this page where it says users can see, well, here's where we want to go in and set up the record rules of filters for that third layer. So here's where I can say user is current user. Now this right here only applies to the third and final layer of data. Anywhere that we want to impact the other layers of data, remember you want to go into the list options, go to the filter here and choose the level that you want to apply the filter to. Now, I know we went really fast in this video, but there's a lot to unpack. This is a really powerful view, but I hope that this gave you at least a taste of what's possible inside of the list interface view. I hope you got a ton of value from it. If you have any questions, be sure to drop them wherever you found the video. And in the meantime, keep on building.